Now we will be discussing about the tumors. So as previously discussed, in any X-ray, before we read, we have to look for this all adequacy of the film. So it's a adequately exposed film. It's the X-rays of bilateral hip joint, anteroposterior view, showing bilateral innominate bone, lower lumbar and sacrococcygeal vertebra, bilateral proximal femora, and it's a lateral view of this right hip, since it is marked here rightly, right hip. So now, as previously told, there is a pathology is in the proximal femur. It's a proximal femur. This is in proximal femur, which part? It is a metaphyseal part. The pattern of destruction is a geographic type. Geographic. It's a geographic. Morphology is lytic, lytic type. Then matrix is here. It is neither chondroid nor osteoid. It looks some lytic side where we should not describe about the matrix. Then after that, whether there is periosteal reaction or not. So here we are not seeing any periosteal reaction. Then we'll look for the soft tissue. So soft tissue is not that much involved. There is not much swelling seen. This the soft tissue of this part is comparable, almost comparable to this part. So it looks like a some benign tumor of the proximal femur of a, and age is very important, because depending upon the age, the certain age has a certain predilection for the certain tumors. So these are the expansile lytic lesion in the proximal femora of 21 years old male. So this can be either simple bone cyst or fibrous dysplasia. So these are the plain X-rays of knee joint, showing anteroposterior and lateral view, showing distal part of the femur and whole of the tibia of a skeletally immature person. Here say you can see the open physis, and pathology lies here in the proximal tibia. There is a pathology is here. So here you cannot see the well defined pattern. So it is neither moth eaten neither geographic. So it is permeative. You cannot see whether the normal bone or pathological. You cannot easily differentiate between the normal bone and pathologic bone here. So here you can see a faint area of demarcation, so you cannot clearly demarcate. So this is but it is more sclerotic, and the morphology of the destruction is, it is more sclerotic, means it is osteoid type, or it's a blastic type. You can see the blastic type of, and matrix. Matrix means this area looks bony, so it can be, you can call osteoid, osteoid matrix. Since it is a permeative, the zone of transition is wide. Zone of transition means you cannot differentiate between, clearly demarcate between normal bone and pathological bone. So this is, there is wide zone of transition that differentiate between benign tumor and malignant tumor. After that, you have to look for the periosteal reaction. Here you are seeing in lateral views, you can see the periosteal reactions which are perpendicular to the bone. So this is called the Xray appearance. These are radiating periosteal reaction. This is the Xray appearance. And here you can see the elevated periosteum here. This is elevated periosteum, and you will see here few sclerotic part, and this is the Codman triangle, though it is not clear. So you can also appreciate here, this is a Codman triangle here. This is Codman triangle. So this is a classical example of osteosarcoma. So this is how we read the X-ray now. To summarize, these are plain X-rays of knee joint swaying, distal femur and whole tibia, anteroposterior and lateral view of skeletally immature person swaying, permeative blastic lesion in the metaphysis of the tibia with chondroid type of periosteal reaction and Codman's triangle, most probably osteosarcoma of the proximal tibia. Now these are the plain X-ray of knee joint showing distal femur, half of the tibia and fibula of immature skeleton with pathology in the proximal tibia, which shows a bony outgrowth at the its posterior part and its middle part, posterior middle part of the metaphysis of the proximal tibia, which is directed away from the physis, and the medullary cavity of the tumor is continuous with the medullary cavity of the parent bone, and it has a well defined margin, and there is no periosteal reaction. This is characteristic feature of osteochondroma. These are the plain X-rays of arm, anteroposterior and lateral view, swaying shoulder joint and the elbow joint of a immature skeleton. Here you can see the proximal physis, and there is a permeative destruction of whole tibia, and there is a mixed type of matrix. You can see mixed type of destruction. There is some area looks blastic, sclerotic, and some area looks lytic, and there is very wide zone of transition. You cannot differentiate between normal bone and abnormal bone, and with the lamellated type of periosteal reaction. Here there are multiple layer of periosteal reaction. You can see multiple layer of periosteal reaction. The most likely it is, and it's a diaphyseal tumor. Most likely it is a Ewing sarcoma of shaft of humerus.